Další prezentace bude od společnosti Quantum. Kdo zná Agoru, nejspíš zná i Quantum, protože Quantum na českém a slovenském trhu zastupujeme už takřka čtvrt století. Hlavně tedy bude ta přednáška o jejich vlajkové lodi StorNext, který už je ve verzi 7. To je systém, který je nejenom pro média a entertainment, jak bychom řekli tady a umění také na FAMU, ale dá se použít i v běžné firemní infrastruktuře s výhodou. A dále budou zmíněny novinky v oblasti zálohovacího hardware. A co vás chci jenom povzbudit, když nebudete něčemu rozumět, nebo budete potřebovat doplnění, nebojte se psát otázky do chatu, nebo přímo k nám na mail do Agory, rádi se s vámi sejdeme. Zeptám se, jestli byly nějaké otázky k Dellu, nebyly? OK. So, now I hope, Massimiliano, you can hear me. Are you here? Are you ready?
I can. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, Massimiliano.
I will share my screen.
When you have been here at FAMU for the last time?
Well, it was probably, right before the COVID. If I'm not wrong, it was like Christmas, not last Christmas, the previous one. I got very good memories of you guys at FAMU.
Yes, and your machines here at FAMU works very well. They use them a lot. So we are happy that you are with us now here. So it's your turn.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you. Thank you. I will share my screen. Okay. I hope you can see my screen now. So my idea today is to provide you guys and welcome everybody, first of all, a short update of Quantum today. I mean, in the last few months, despite the COVID, we were really, really active announcing new product and refreshing existing one. Okay, so from this point of view, we have now a new version of our StorNext platform. We are at version 7, so we moved one major major version ahead. And on top of that, we did a major refresh of our appliance family. So we recently announced the H series, which is made by the H2000, which is a new, let's say, innovative storage focused at mid and entertainment projects. The H4000, which is our, let's say, main platform, basically the platform that runs the StorNext services and at the same time can provide data services. So it's like an hyper-converged appliance. And I would like also to remind basically the beauty of our F-Series, which is the NVMe storage developed and optimized for StorNext. After that, I will give a quick overview over the ActiveScale object storage systems, which is basically a company we purchased a few times back from Western Digital. It's a company providing, well, now it's a product providing object storage services for a variety of different tasks. It can be used as an archive repository for the video projects. It can be used to create private clouds. It can be used to store backups and to protect backups against ransomware and for a variety of other projects. Okay, so it's a very versatile system that we purchased. And on top of that, I mean, you know that our heart is still beating with tape libraries somehow. And we also have some interesting updates to share with you about our tape library business. Okay, so yeah, just to give you like a better understanding of where we are now. Today, with these new products and the new acquisitions we did, we have a very complete set of data management technologies. Okay, so we are now in the condition, of course, to provide very, very strong data protection and very strong media and entertainment solutions. But on top of that, we can provide all the layers, all the platforms, all the intelligence to really provide data management solution. Okay, so we are not talking about only, let's say, repositories, storages, but we are talking about a combined platform that really provides a very deep control over the way your applications or the users are accessing data. Okay, we can improve the experience of editors. We can improve the experience of backup administrators. And at the same time, we can really provide a very integrated solution to keep the whole environment under a very deep control. Okay, so probably today, Quantum is the company that worldwide can provide the wider and more integrated set of family for the data management. Okay, no matter if it's media and entertainment, no matter if it's backup, no matter if it's other kind of vertical projects. We have probably the right solution for you. So as a starter, I would like to go into some more details about our new platform, our new StorNext 7. As you know, StorNext 7, it's a platform that has been designed to manage big amounts of big files. Okay, and when I talk about big files, big unstructured files, probably video images are the kind of files that are growing faster and faster. Some companies like IDC, Gartner, they estimate that by 2025, 80% of the data produced worldwide will be unstructured files. And among the unstructured file family, probably the video and the images are playing a very, very important role. Just think about what happens when you park your car, right? You take a picture of the parking spot, and that picture will be stored somewhere on your phone, on iCloud, somewhere. Okay, so just imagine the amount of data that are produced every day. So we really have a big boost in terms of capacity required to manage this data. And of course, there is a big requirement in terms of technology that you need to basically to store and above all to manage all this data explosion. Okay, so in Quantum, we are able to provide solutions for any kind of requirement of workflow, of solutions to basically manage, edit, process, and archive video and image data. Okay, we have solutions that can really go from the very beginning, when and where the data are produced, up to the solutions that we have, of course, deployed inside our FAMU France facilities. So solutions to basically edit, process this data. And when the processing, when the editing is over, we also have the same solutions that can archive, can deploy to cloud, can use the cloud as a production tier. Okay, so we can really, really help from the very beginning to the very end of the life cycle. Okay, and this is possible because of the StorNext platform, which is really the core of all our solutions. Basically, the platform is made, as a quick recap, by two main components. You have a very fast and performing file system, which has been developed by us, of course, by Quantum, which has been designed for collaborative video workflow. Okay, so to make the collaboration between editors, between applications, between all the elements that build your video solutions, to make this collaboration as fast as possible with the highest throughput and with the lowest possible latency. We can basically present the files that are managed by the file system across a variety of protocols, variety of storage, variety of operating systems. We can deploy our own, let's say, proprietary protocols, which really, really boost the performance, but we can also basically present the file system using standard protocols, NAS protocols, S3 protocols. Okay, so it's a very flexible file system, the one that StorNext is providing. And on top of the file system, we also have a second component that somehow, let's say, expands this file system system across multiple tiers of storage. So basically, StorNex is not limited to fast disks only, but you can build your own storage solution made by different tiers of storage, okay? So that you can make sure that your video file are stored in the tier, in the kind of storage where it makes more sense from a performance perspective, but also from a price per terabyte perspective. Okay, so you can basically expand your file system across a very fast disk, nearline disk, the cloud, tape library, and object storage. Okay, so you can basically create a very flexible solution. Okay.
Massimo, I apologize for interrupting you, but we have some questions here for you, but not factual questions, but questions about your screen. Are you able to share your PowerPoint presentation in full screen mode?
If you can see it, yes, it's better. Okay, yeah. Because I'm not used to Zoom, unfortunately. I belong to the Microsoft family here with Teams.
Okay,
but it's here. Better now.
That's fine. Okay, thank you, and you can continue.
Okay, so basically, this diagram here represents, you know, the full potentiality, the full power of our StorNex. And the good thing is that all the complexity is hidden by the platform itself. So what your users see is just like a normal volume, okay, on their Mac, on their Windows PC, on their Linux machine. Okay, and whatever is behind this volume is managed in a transparent way from StorNex. You can have like your storage, your video storage shared by online, nearline. You can have like on the back the cloud, the tape library, whatever, and everything is presented as a single volume. With the latest version of StorNex, you can also use the cloud not only as an archive tier, but also as an extended online tier. Okay, so you can basically use the cloud to deploy remote production and to make your data accessible, for example, to remote editors or to cloud-based applications like cloud transcoding, cloud rendering, you know, this kind of online services, and still basically keep all this data as part of the file system. So basically, with the new StorNex 7, we are seriously making the full production lifecycle much easier. So basically, the new version is StorNex 7, as we said. With StorNex 7, we have made the architecture of the file system much easier, much more flexible, but also from, let's say, a licensing perspective, it's easier to manage, because now, I mean, you don't have to worry anymore about all the features and all the different licenses that previously you had to pick, you know, to create the project for your needs. With the new StorNex 7, basically, we have an open bar model. Okay, you just pay a subscription, okay, which can change from year to year, for example. So it really can adapt to your workflows. And inside the subscription, you're entitled to use any single license, any single option that the StorNex is providing. Okay, so it's very, very flexible, this new approach. From an architecture standpoint, I will not enter into very deep technical details, but what we have done is basically move from, let's say, a monolithic approach, okay, into a virtual machine approach. It's not really a virtual machine here. We have containerized, okay, all the main components of StorNex, so created smaller virtual machines, smaller dockers that talk together, okay, to provide the services. This means basically many things, but above all, it means that the file system today is more agile, is more flexible, okay? And this transformation of architecture has made the file system even faster, okay? We have recently shared our specifications at the website that you see here, spec.org, which somehow compares you know, different architecture, different solutions into similar markets. And the result is that StoreNext is the world's fastest file system platform. Okay, we are faster than a lot of different other similar solutions. Okay, and this very important result means that with the same investment, you can work with higher resolutions, you can work with more file streams, you can have more editors, more applications that work on the same storage. Okay, so this solution means that with StoreNext, okay, with the same hardware, you can do more, you can produce more, and you can be more effective in your work. Okay, so among the features, I mean, we did lots of changes in StoreNext 7, but actually the main features of this new version is that, first of all, we have taken the concept of tiering, of storage tiering, which is something that already exists in the traditional IT market. We have taken this tiering idea into the video production. Okay, so with StoreNext now, we can basically have different kind of storages, for example, a very fast NVMe storage or a very fast SSD, where you want to provide basically performance, IOPS, right? And you can also have at the same time capacity storage, and the StoreNext will basically make sure that the files are moved up and down depending on the workload, depending on your need. So if you need to process some specific files that where you need performance, StoreNext will promote this file on the fastest storage tier. When the production is over, when you don't need basically that space for that project anymore, StoreNext will move that back to make the resource available for the next project. Okay, and again, this will be totally transparent for the users. Okay, so it will be something where users, they will just see the benefits of this. And from investment perspective, the idea is that you don't have to purchase a very big NVMe storage. You can purchase just a small amount on VMe storage. The rest of the money goes into the capacity storage, and you will still see basically the best of the two worlds: performance and IOPS and capacity. Okay, so basically the investment will be smaller and the result will be the same as a very big NVMe, a very big flash array. And on top of that, I mean, we have also did, let's say, some general improvements over the previous version of StoreNext, which was StoreNext 6. Just a recap, StoreNext 6 was already a big revolution compared to previous versions, because with StoreNext 6, we have introduced lots of very interesting features for the video. We have introduced the file system auditing, which is something that is, mandatory if you want to work in productions for this kind of big streamers like Netflix, Amazon, or Disney. Okay, they require the level of control that StoreNext can provide. Okay, so with StoreNext 6, we deployed like file system audit, we deployed the quality of service, we deployed replication. So with StoreNext 6, we already did a big improvement in terms of features, in terms of user experience compared to previous versions. But with StoreNext 7, we have gone even further. We have improved the security of the files and the way the users, they access to the file system. We have improved the number and the kind of protocols that we support. So now you can basically access the file system natively with any kind of protocol and any kind of operating system that you prefer. It works with Fibre Channel, it works with InfiniBand, it works with Ethernet connections from 1 gigabit up to 100 gigabit, okay? So we can use proprietary protocols, we can use generic protocols like NFS, like SMB, like S3, okay? So I mean, we are really flexible in terms of protocol support. And of course, we are really flexible also in terms of operating system that we support with our proprietary protocol, which requires the installation of a driver, right? An agent on the operating system. So with the new version of StoreNext, we support all the modern operating system versions, Big Sur, Red Hat 8, and all the other modern operating systems. An important improvement that we have done with StoneX 7 is the GUI. We have redesigned the full GUI of the file system. So from one side, I mean, we have basically unified into a single into a single GUI all the main components of the solution. Okay, previously you had to look at least at two or three different GUIs to have like the full control over your solution. Now with StoneX 7, we have a single point where you can basically administer and monitor the full environment. And on top of that, the GUI now has got a more modern look and feel. Okay, which means that it's basically easier to use. So the learning curve for the StoneX now is much, much faster compared to the past. Okay, so basically in terms of StoneX, we did a very big improvements, much more flexibility, much more performance. The fact that now StoneX is running, as I said, not like a monolithic file system, so a software that you install on physical servers, but it's a combination of different containers, of different virtual machines, makes it very easy the path to the cloud. And this is a preview. It's not something that is on the market, but it will be very soon. With StoneX 7, we are now able to use like a hybrid approach. Right, we can have, of course, an on-premise approach, which is the traditional way you use StoneX, but we can also provide a cloud-based version of the file system. Okay, so the idea will be that we will be able to basically launch StoneX instances running on the cloud. They will access the storages on the cloud, and we will be able to either access using basically a variety of all the protocols that StoneX allows to cloud-based file system from on-premise, from your local office, from your local production facility, okay? But we will be able also to basically share the files between the local environment with the cloud environment, okay? So we will be able to have like a hybrid environment which will be running both on the cloud and on the local facility. Okay, so this is the project that we will be launching very soon, and this is possible because of the new architecture of StoneX. But again, keeping an eye on what happens on the on-premise space, we have created a new family of appliances to run StoneX locally in your facility. This is called H-Series, okay? And it's a hyper-converged platform. Okay, it's a platform made by two U servers, which of course can be expanded to accommodate the capacity and the performance and the requirements you might have. But the idea is that now you don't have servers, storages, and expansion nodes. I mean, we have consolidated everything into basically hyper-converged appliances, which runs the StoneX services, the data services. All of them are virtualized. And in just 2U, you will be able to run basically all the components of a traditional StoneX architecture. You will still have, I'm moving back to the slide here, you will still have at least two blade servers running the StoneX services. So you will have the same level of robustness, of high availability, but everything is consolidated into a 2U machine, which of course can be expanded. Okay. Again, the idea is to provide not only infrastructure services, because we said this in the beginning of the presentation, we are moving from infrastructure only to real data management solution. So the idea is that with this kind of new architecture, we will be able to also integrate third-party applications running from the same appliance. Okay, so for example, the MAM Okay, you might be aware that Quantum last year also purchased a new company called Squarebox, which is the editor of a MUM solution called CatDV. Okay, so the idea, of course, is that we will also be able to launch a product which will integrate the storage provided by StoreNext with the MUM, for example. So with the same 2U machine, you're going to have a very powerful file system, the storage that you need, and the MUM on top. So basically the data management layer on top. Okay, so again, this is going to be a very disruptive technology in this world. Okay, so basically this solution is called H-Series, and specifically the solution that I'm showing here is the H4000, which has been just announced and just been launched. On top of that, we also have, let's say, a second family of solutions called F-Series. F-Series is just a storage. In this case, we are still not able to run StoreNext services on that. So you might consider the F-Series as a disk, but it's a disk which is controlled by our software-defined architecture. Okay, so it's not like a write disk, but it's controlled by our storage. So Quantum has developed the software that controls the way you store your read data on the disk, which means that these solutions, the H-Series and the F-Series, are optimized to work with StoreNext. These are not arrays. These are not storages that we can use with StoreNext and with an Oracle database. All these solutions are solutions for video. Okay, and our solutions for video in a StoreNext environment. So the F-Series, for example, it's an NVMe storage solution. So it only use NVMe storages that with only 1U or 2U, depending on the model, is able to provide approximately 20 gigabytes of performance, 20 gigabytes per second of performance, which is huge. Okay, so the idea of this F-Series is, of course, to be used as a standalone product in case you need lots of performance for very heavy workflows, 4K not compressed, 8K not compressed as well, or an environment where you have, like, let's say, more traditional streams, but lots of editors, lots of users, okay? Or you need also a lot of IOPS, for example. So in case you need IOPS for special effects, for rendering, this is probably the right solution. On top of that, this solution fits very well with the tiering that we launched with StoreNext 7, because they can provide, let's say, the first tier. Okay, so you have like an F-Series on top of a traditional storage array, and StoreNext 7 moves your data up and down according to the usage of these files. Okay, so you can basically purchase an F-Series to be, let's say, the first tier of a multi-tier solution. Okay, so basically, this is an overview of where we are going on the production side. On top of that, as I said in the beginning of the presentation, we also purchased a company. Well, actually, it's not a company. It was like a division of Western Digital, which is called. Oh, sorry, I don't know what happened. So we purchased this company from Western Digital. Actually, Quantum was one of the founders, one of the investors in the original startup. It's an European startup. It was called AmpliData. It's based in Belgium, that during the year basically was sold to Hitachi, then Western Digital, and we ended up purchasing again this company because we really believe in the project and we really have a lot of experience in this space, and we really think that the object storage technologies, they are going to have a very important role in the workflows of the next few years. Okay, why an object storage? Probably you're familiar with this kind of technologies, but just as a very quick recap, basically, object storage is a different way to think about the storages, okay? Especially when you need a lot of amount of data, lots of scalability, the right solutions, the traditional disks are not enough, okay? They cannot scale enough. They cannot protect the data enough, and they are not easy to scale to multi-petabytes with the flexibility you need. Okay, so basically, object storage is providing a different, let's say, paradigm over the storage. The idea is that the object storage will be basically, let's say, a tier between the primary disk and the tape library. Okay, somehow it's providing a better cost per terabytes, especially if you need to scale in a multi-petabytes capacity space, right? And it's providing, of course, a little less performance than a faster disk, okay? But it's still a disk, okay? So you can use the object storage just like you would be using, let's say, a nearline disk, for example, okay? Or a solution to basically store your backup, because, I mean, this is not just for video. Object storage has got a variety of use cases, okay? So it's basically a different approach with storage that provides more or less the same performance as an online disk, but has got a better scalability, a better protection, and also a better price per terabytes. Okay, so basically the idea is that we will be selling object storage as a complementary solution to primary disk and tape library. Okay, so it's somewhere in the middle. Our object storage technology, ActiScale, is pretty unique in the object storage landscape, okay? First of all, because it's really, really, really scalable. Potentially, we have no limits. We can build namespaces with no limitations. So however big is the requirement, with ActiScale, we can accommodate this requirement. So we can really provide solutions from the smaller, let's say, post-production studio that wants a flexible solution to build a private cloud, for example, because they don't want to put the data in Amazon, no? Because they don't think it's a valid business model, for example, and they want to create their own archive based on a private cloud. Okay, or we can build a solution for the very big TV channel that needs lots of petabytes as an archive, but they want to move away from tape or at least have one of the copies on a disk tier. Okay, so I mean, it's really flexible. It's really fast. As I said before, I mean, it's not as fast as a production disk probably, but again, it's very fast. And we have a solution made by two layers. We have basically one fast layer that provides performance and one capacity layers that provides the scalability. So we can provide at the same time performance and capacity. And also the way basically we share the information across all the disks, all the elements of an ActiScale, it's pretty unique. Because I mean, we have this algorithm called DDP, which provides a very good availability and a very easy management. Okay, we can very easily add additional nodes, scale the system, dismiss nodes. We can avoid worrying about a disk that fails. Okay, I mean, this is all based on erasure code algorithms, which is different from RAID. It's an algorithm erasure coding that basically allows a better scalability and a better data protection of the data you store on this system. So with our DDP protocol, we are able to basically provide a much better availability and basically scale very, very easily. At the same time, this system, via a second set of algorithms that we implement called DDR, Dynamic Data Repair, it's always checking your data. It's always checking in background for basically integrity, for data correctness, okay? And on top of that, we can also deploy, let's say, private cloud solution based on 3 geos. Okay, so we can create namespaces that are not only local on your data center, but that can spread between multiple data centers. On top of that, since we are talking about a solution that potentially will basically archive the main copy of your data forever, okay, we need to provide features that somehow mitigate the risk of ransomware attacks. Okay, and this is valid not only for video archive, but it's valid for any kind of data. Even if you use these appliances to store, for example, your Vim backup, okay, you want to be sure that your long-term backups are protected by any kind of ransomware attack, any kind of virus attack. Okay, so we provide two main features for this. One is the versioning. We support multiple versions of the same file. Okay, so from this point of view, even if the current version for any reason is contaminated or it's deleted by mistake, we can move back to previous version. And on top of that, we support some kind of warm capabilities. So we can lock the object that you store into a specific folder, no, of this object storage system. So we can make specific files or the full folder, the technical name is bucket, okay, the partition of your object storage, we can make all those files undeletable and unchangeable for a certain period of time. Okay, so you can make sure that no external applications, authorized or not authorized, will be able to delete your files or to change your files. And this is a great, great protection against any kind of threat. So this is the technology, okay, the background of the technology. In terms of products, we have also a very interesting product portfolio because we can really accommodate any kind of need. We can go from small environments where we have like an entry point of 432 terabytes. So I think it's quite in line with the entry requirements of an object storage archive solution. Okay, and this is the P100E3. Okay, so with just three nodes and 432 terabytes, you have like an entry point to the ActiveScale family. And then we have the bigger brother, the P100, okay, which is basically scaling the capabilities of the P100E3. And this is scalable up to 27 petabytes. Okay, so a single file system of a namespace rather than file system of 27 petabytes. And after that, we have like the enterprise version. It's just been launched. It's the X200, and it can go from one petabyte to infinite. Okay, potentially we have no limits on the scalability that we can provide. Okay. In terms of a topology of solutions, we are also very, very flexible. We have like, of course, we can deploy the solutions into a single site. Okay, so into your data center, whatever number of racks, it can run with no problem. We can have a hybrid solution. So you can have like the ActiveScale at your data center that replicates selected data to cloud providers, because of course, this is fully compatible with S3, as you would expect by this kind of solution. So we can replicate to Amazon, for example, to have a second copy. Or we can replicate it to a second and active scale, of course. So you can basically have like disaster recovery solutions, but we can also create like multiple geo solution to create your own private cloud across different data centers. So in this case, the file system will not be replicated, but it will be, let's say, distributed between multiple data centers. Okay, so I mean, really, really lots of flexibility in terms of deployments. And what about the use case? As I said, this system, it's a perfect fit for any kind of archive requirement. Okay, so for the M&E world, of course, it's a great tool. But it's not only a tool for the M&E world. I mean, we see a lot of customer purchasing these systems for backup, for example. We support, of course, the majority of modern backup application. And this is also certified as a Vim-ready repository. So this means that Vim can send your backup to the ActiveScale for the long-term retention, for example. So all those backups that you need to store on a storage repository for many years, and you want an additional layer of security against ransomware, against viruses, whatever. I mean, ActiScale, it's probably a great fit for that. Okay, but again, I mean, we see a lot of customers purchasing ActiScale for backup, for video archive, but also for HPC. Okay, it's a great archive for HPC projects. Okay, we work with different partners active in the HPC world. We see customers purchasing ActiScale for big data projects. Okay, so I mean, really, and again, I got a recap here, but the idea is that ActiScale is really an object, a repository that can accommodate lots of different requirements. Of course, backup is one of them. We are certified Veeam. Okay, so it's a great match for any kind of Veeam environment. It's an environment that we see a lot of success in the M&E market. Okay, so together with the StorNext solution, but in general, I mean, it's a product that fits any kind of requirement of disk capacity and disk scalability. Okay, so any kind of requirement where you need to basically create some kind of private cloud, private repository for big amounts of data, this is a great match. Okay, and it's for sure the future. Okay, it's the future because basically it's an alternative to tape. But, and I want to finish my presentation talking about tape. Tape still plays a very, very important role in any kind of long-term preservation project. Why? Because tape library, because it provides what it's called air gap. So a physical air, let's say wall between the servers and the applications and the data, okay, are still the last resource against ransomware, against virus attack. And it's still the cheapest storage on hard. Okay, the price per terabytes of a tape cartridge is unmatched. You got no disk storage that can match the price per terabytes of a tape library. Okay, so still it's very, very used. As a quantum, you probably know, we are the number one manufacturer of tape libraries in the world. Okay, so we are still designing and investing a lot in research and development of tape libraries. Today, we have a very complete product range. Okay, the name of our product family, it's a Scalar, okay? And we basically have entry-level products, the Scalar i3, scalable up to 400 slots, the mid-range product, the Scalar i6, which scales up to 800 slots, and the enterprise product, the Scalar i6000, which scales to more than 12,000 slots. And we sell a lot of these libraries in the backup, in the data protection space, and in the video archive space. Basically, most of the banks, lots of banks in Czech Republic, they are also running i6K or i6 libraries. A very, very important, transportation company. I don't want to do the name, but they got a huge data center in Czech Republic. They're running a lot of i6K and also lots of TV channels. Else they are running this kind of libraries. So this product family, the Scalar tape library, is still very, very, very alive, okay? And we still invest a lot in developing new features. So we are about to launch the new LTO9 format, which will be, I mean, as you probably know, Quantum is part of the LTO consortium, okay? So together with IBM, together with HP, Quantum is one of the companies that design the standard of tape technology for the future, okay? So now we are LTO8, and we are about to launch LTO9. It will be available right after summer. So in October 2021, we will be basically start selling LTO9 drives, which will provide 18 terabytes of native capacity on cartridge and 45 terabytes of compressed capacity on each cartridge. So basically, we are going to provide a very good density in terms of capacity and also very good performance. Each LTO9 drive will be able to read and write at 400 megabyte per second in native mode and 1 gigabyte per second in compressed mode. So each drive will be very close to a disk array in terms of performance, in terms of throughput. Okay, we can already sell our products with a pre-purchase program. So we basically sell LTO8 today, and while LTO9 is available, our customers will be entitled to basically replace the LTO8 with LTO9 for free. Okay, so I mean, stay tuned, because very soon we will have LTO9 ready. But on top of that, we are also investing not only on the hardware side, but we are also investing in the software side, in the feature side of the tape libraries. So for example, still in terms of ransomware protection, still in terms of air gap that I mentioned before, you know that the tape library is very useful in terms of ransomware protection, because basically the tapes are separated from the network. If a cartridge is not in the drive, it cannot be changed. Okay, and on top of that, you can physically remove the cartridges from the tape library, okay, and put these cartridges somewhere else. So no virus will be able to basically take the cartridge from your shelf and put it into a drive. It's impossible, okay? So it's a great way to protect your data. But still, I mean, this is not very comfortable, because you still need to go close to your tape library and physically remove the cartridges. Okay, so you might have your tape library far away from your operator PC. Okay, so maybe it's in the service provider data center, maybe it's in the last floor of your building. Okay, so still it's not very comfortable extracting the cartridges. And on top of that, you might risk to lose some cartridge, to have a corruption of your data because of the manipulation of the cartridge. Okay, so we designed a unique feature from us called Active Vault. With Active Vault, you can create an invisible partition inside the tape library. So just like an external shelf where you store one of the copies or all the cartridges, okay, but inside the tape library. It's an invisible partition, so no application and above all, no virus, no malware can access to that partition, because it's disconnected from the network. Okay, but it's inside the tape library. Okay, so instead of physically exporting the cartridges, you can configure the library to basically move all the exported cartridges into this Active Vault partition. Okay, so basically you have like a secure shelf, untouchable from any kind of application, okay, inside the tape library. Okay, so you don't need to go close to the tape library to move these cartridges. You don't risk of losing the cartridges. You don't risk of corrupting the cartridges. Okay, so a great feature to protect your data stored into a Scala tape library. And this is unique from us. And the second and last feature I would like to describe is the EDLM. We discussed already that basically one of the main use today of a tape library is long-term retention, backup data, video archive, okay? So you want to make sure that your data are accessible when you need to access them, okay? So maybe in 1 year time, maybe in 5 year time, okay? But the day you need to read something from a specific cartridge, you want to make sure that the cartridge is in a full condition, okay? So our libraries can automatically and proactively scan and check all the cartridges that are stored into the tape library. Okay, so in a normal situation they can do the scan and provide a report, but if you use our libraries, so the Scala libraries, together with a StoreNext environment, in a StoreNext environment, the library and the StoreNext can talk together. So if the library see that a specific cartridge is about to break, it will automatically start a cloning operation into a new cartridge and speak with the StoreNext to update the StoreNext databases. So basically, the protection, okay, of all your cartridge archive will be automatically and transparent for the users and the applications. So the result is that no matter when you will be reading a specific data on a specific cartridge, but you're guaranteed that the data, that the video files will be accessible because the cartridge is in good condition. And this is only possible with our EDLM feature, which again is a feature that we developed specifically for our Scala libraries. And that's it from my side. I think I was able, I hope actually, I was able to give you a complete overview of where we are today in terms of video solutions, in terms of appliances, in terms of storage, but also in terms of object storage and tape solutions for not only video projects, but also basically backup and data protection projects.
Okay, thank you very much, Massimo.
Thanks to you.
Thank you for your cooperation for last 25 years. Thank you for your presentation for last 15 minutes. We didn't receive any questions. So if there will be any questions in the next few minutes or hours, we will send you these questions. But for now, thank you. And
thank you.
For everyone, coffee break is here. So thank you, Massimo. Pro všechny máme teďka přestávku 10 minut.